do women think, you know, let's, if we were to unpack the moms here, you said that they're not aware that they're doing that. So they think that what they're doing is the healthy versions of
mother, being a mother.
Mothering. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And okay.
Yeah.
And like, and I guess, you know, men, you know, again, I know it's dangerous to generalize, like I get that. So, and I say that on there. So we're just trying to come up with examples and stuff like that. But men, when they're grooming, they're not thinking that I'm just trying to be a good dad here when they're setting up to abuse their children. Right. So there is a different.
Yeah. For men, it's more overt. There's an understanding that I have some sexual needs that this little girl is going to meet for me. That is not what I see in the moms. The moms are cut off from all of that, and they see it as mothering, but it, but they're getting their needs met from that little boy. And I've had mothers say, this is my little man. You're now the man of the house. And, you know, that can be exciting to a little boy whose father's distant or gone, or he's closer to the mother. I want to go back to what you said, because it's true. We stop touching little boys earlier than we stop touching little girls. And we teach little boys to stop touching each other and to reject all things that are what we call in our culture feminine. Feelings, emotions, naming. People forget this. And then the little boy grows up into a man, has no access to feelings, touch is all sexualized, and we shame him instead of remembering, wait a minute, you know, so when he's that little boy and he's not being touched, and now his mother's touching him, it can feel really good. It's a longing to be touched. Mm-hmm. So that it can feel normal to him.